this ocean currents, they rises and lower the temperature of the coastal areas because they affect the coastal areas first. The Gulf Stream in the southwest and the Alaskan Current in the northwest are one current. Let me show you one thing. Here, this is Alaskan Current and this is Gulf. Why this is known as Gulf Stream? Because this comes from this way area and this is Gulf. And it comes from here, Alaska. This is Alaskan Current. They are warm current. That means they are hot. The coastal parts of the Alaska are frost free even in winter due to this warm current. As they are warm, they keep the coast frost free during winter because the Alaskan Current is not allowing the snow to frost as they are warm. How will you understand? You boil water, you heat up water and you take some ice cubes and you drop on it and you will see that it will start melting. Such things happen in these coastal areas also. Next, the Californian Current and the Labrador Current. Now, the Californian Current in the southwest and the Labrador in the northeast are cold currents. Here comes the Labrador Current from here. See? Coming from here, so it is cold current. And the Californian Current. See, Californian Current. This is also cold current. These two current are cold current, and cold currents, when they move along the coast, which make them flow dry, because as being cold, they frost the moisture air particles that is present in the air, and so when they flow, it remains dry. Now the Californian Current in the western part of USA, that means western part of USA, here what is done? As it is cold, it makes this place desert. And the mixing of the, from here when the Labrador Current is coming and it is mixing with this Gulf Current that is coming from here. Let me see and show you. The Gulf Current is coming from here and the Labrador is coming from here. When they combine together, when hot water and cold water will combine, what will happen? What will happen? It comes and combine near the coast of Newfoundland, and as it is combining, it makes the water rich for fishing grounds, because this Atlantic cod, swordfish, haddock, shellfish are different fish are found there, because due to this warm and cold current here, many planktons are found in the water which attracts fish, because planktons are fish food. All these factors that we have talked about have a great variety of climate in all this makes the climate of America of different varieties, like the tundra and the Arctic type. Now what type of climate is this? This is the coastal part of Canada and Alaska, bordering near the Arctic Ocean in the extreme north of the continent, where they experience tundra type of climate. Tundra type of climate means very cold throughout the year. Summers are very short, cool. I think I have told you that Canada is having cold due to this reason, because here near it, and Alaska also, any rain is not occurring as the snow, and the areas are snow covered most of the years. And in tundra regions, what type of vegetation is found? Here, the vegetation are mostly mosses, leeches, grasses, dwarf bushes. Subsoils means because the topsoil is frozen throughout the year. The animals have big furs, that's why we can find polar bear here, musk, ox, caribou, arctic fox, very common animals found here. Some have thick fat in the, under their skin, which make them survive. The seashell, whales and walrus are some of the animals that are found in this forest. Okay, today only two. Thank you.